Hello friends, welcome to the Smart Exceller. This video is a continuation for Power Query. And I'm going to show you simple errors where we can lose hope and get frustrated and panicked in Power Query. So this is my previous video which I made, and you can see I have did the data cleansing and I got 604 rows, and it's almost 540 columns, and this is the database I have made. So if I want to duplicate this, I want to show you some of the areas where we can get errors. So I want to remove some of the columns, and you can see most of the things is like when I'm having this into a whole number and stuff like that. But now if I see that if I purposely if I remove the some of the elements, you know, it's going to be in a text. So if I make this into a text and make this into, so then move concentrate on the totals, and this is also a text. And this is also a text. So let's not do this one, and let it be whole number. The total. So total for third year, let me make this into a text. So in this way, if you just forget to make this into a whole number, and if you leave this as a text, and what is going to impact on your data model, that is what I'm going to show you. So I want to make a new table, pivot table in a new worksheet. So I'm going to make a new worksheet. So before that, I want to make into a connection. I want to make into a new worksheet, and let's see what is the impact on that. So same way, I'm going to have the things on board, and I'm going to make this a site, a service, a description. So now the total, when I select it, you can see it's going in this column in the row. So I want to put it in the value. Let me put in the value. So you can see it is going on count now. Total, again it's gone here. So let me remove that. And let me drop and drop. So you can see how it is going into count. And third one also, you can see. That's not a, sorry, not a 3-year total. If you see the 3-year total, let me first go to this. It has gone to the count. You can see how this has been changed into a count. Now if I close this, you can see it is going in a count. This is the biggest error. This is a very smallest error, but it is one of the biggest error when you find this sort of data manipulation. So if you make this into a sum, you can see you're getting wrong values. So if you want to convert this into a sum, you can see how it's getting a wrong value, because you have made a big mistake in that one. So let's change that. And by the way, I want to show you one more thing that So when I go to this, and when I take this total third year, so it's not really sum. So when I'm going to go to the total of third year, You can see it has come here directly and it has taken the sum properly. The sum is taken properly. The reason behind that is, this is the data of this. The reason behind that is I have not changed for that one. So you can see it's in alphanumeric. So anyhow, if I remove this, let me make this also a decimal number. And now you can see the total has been changed into proper format. So now when I go and close and load, now you can see the sum has been corrected. So this is a very important subject, you know. Always be careful when you have a database in the proper format. Go always try to keep the things very, very crucial, and it's very critical that if you have any mistakes, if you do any mistake, instead of if you make this a text, automatically it will affect your data analysis. So this video is the example for this, for the data analysis. So next video I'm going to show you how to, if you don't have some formulas in such a way, how to take this into data model and how to get the results for some of the areas. So if you can't write this type of formulas, so how to solve this. So I hope you got this video useful and understanding. So let's see in the next video. Thanks for watching. So this video is on Power Query Errors.